Hello, everyone. My name is Jason Piecey, and this is Out of the Fog, a very special episode of Out of the Fog. We recently introduced to you my good friend, director Joe Dominix, and how he's going to be doing some field correspondence work with us for some really interesting topics that relate around the music community, because that's a big part of where he comes from and things that he's passionate about and things that are important to him. And tonight, we're gonna have a conversation with the one and only country music superstar, Mr. Rod Jackson, and sort of it's a heartwarming story. It is a good, good story. And you're gonna get to hear all about it from Mr. Joe Dominix when we come back right after this.
We got a mission.
That sounds like the bad guys teaming up.
It's only just begun.
Whoa.
Watching Rogers TV, St. John's.
Call the Rogers TV viewer response line, email us, or connect with us on social media.
And welcome back to Out of the Fog. Okay, here it is. It is a good story. Joe really knows his way around this because it's his jam. And Mr. Rod Jackson is, well, he's a great musician, he's a great singer, he's a great songwriter, and as you'll hear from this interview, he's a great person. Enjoy.
Hey everybody, it's Joe. I'm here at Reed Music in Mount Pearl, and I'm joined by ECMA and Music NL award-winning country artist, Mr. Rod Jackson. Rod, thanks for being here.
I see you, Joe.
So, Rod, you're doing some shows now with your band, The Perfect Strangers.
Yes, yes. A little over a year ago, actually, we set up a new band. I'd always tried to find people who were like-minded, myself, professional people who you know, who did things the right way.
Absolutely. So you're back. You've done two music videos since you've returned. You did A Guy Like Me, and
yeah,
you've done
yeah.
Angry All the Time.
Well, we started out last year, and I said the first thing we need to do to make an impact as a new band is to get some sort of visual. We had already agreed to do a tour of the summer called the Greatest Country Duets Tour. So I said, okay, let's take a song from that. Let's pick a song that we can do really well. And let's hire a great production company and let's do it. So Roger Maunder, Up Sky
yeah,
Down Films,
Roger Maunder, great filmmaker.
did the video shoot. We did half of it in February up at my cottage in Ocean Pond. And the other half we did at Leaside Manor.
Right.
And we hired some actors and actresses. And anyway, it turned out really well.
Yeah, some great performances in there from,
yeah,
from the actors and,
oh, yeah,
and great,
oh, yeah,
visuals from Roger. He's
yeah,
in the,
oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, you know, the song itself is kind of a dark song. So it wasn't, I guess it was by choice, mostly because we performed the song so well that we did that. It's called Angry All the Time, which is about a husband and a wife who just weren't getting along, and you know, it ends off that they split. So we did that. We went on tour, did the duets tour, came back. We did SAMA Festival in Grand Falls, Windsor, my hometown, your hometown.
My hometown as well, absolutely.
And so we, yeah, and we brought Roger on the road with us because I wanted to do the opposite of Angry All the Time. I wanted to do a song called A Guy Like Me, which is all about having fun. It's a tribute to Grand Falls, Windsor, yeah, the Exploits River.
Absolutely.
My father grew up on the Exploits River salmon fishing. He passed away 10 plus years ago. So I wanted to make sure that we had scenes of, you know, everything across, yeah, the bridge, we used to call it, where the mill was.
Yeah.
Everything from the salmon ladder, seeing the salmon jumping, to us actually doing the performance on stage,
right,
and at the end, a nice tribute to my dad, who we took some shots of people actually salmon fishing.
Yeah,
and then he was there right at the end, and he's kind of looking back and smiling as if to say, you know,
that's a great,
you're
nice
doing,
little tribute at the end of that video.
You're doing all right.
So, Rod, I want to rewind a little bit because you've got an extraordinary story, a backstory of how you got to where we are right now. Let's just talk a bit about your childhood, because you had a few moments in your life that were very impactful and very significant,
yeah,
and some obstacles that you had to overcome. As a child, you were in a car accident.
Yeah.
Well, when I was five, I was run over by a car.
Wow.
Which left me permanently deaf in my right ear. And I had a fractured skull, and I was paralyzed.
Right.
So that's 5 years old. Pretty good, eh?
Yeah.
So when I got clear of that, the thing about that part of it is I lost my memory completely from five back, from the accident back.
Wow.
2 weeks after I got home from the hospital, my mom passed away. So, you know, she fell on the floor in front of me, and that's the kind of thing that never leaves you. And, you know, I could have chosen a lot of different paths to go down in life, most of them not good. Mm. I was the youngest of 10, you know, it wasn't easy. My dad was disabled. He couldn't work. So you got to raise 10 kids and no work. So think about that for a second.
Yeah.
But I don't know, my sister took me aside and raised me. I moved to Corner Brook. I ended up in Mount Pearl, actually, here in Mount Pearl, and finished high school here just up the road, Mary Queen of the World, which is no longer a high school. So to make a long story short, that impacted my life a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, I decided early on that I had to try to do something with my life, even without the guidance of a mother. You know, we still were a tight family as a group, but we couldn't all stay together. So, you know, my sister took me and a couple others, and another one, you know, three or four went off to the mainland.
Right, and we did their part, kind of.
It was time. Mm. After Mom passed away, a big piece of the fabric was gone.
Right.
You know, as it would be for any family.
Well, it's a tough thing to go through at any age, let alone being so.
Well, there's no good thing. There's no good thing about that. The only positive in any of it was the fact that I was so young.
Yeah.
So it didn't affect me as much as it affected some of the other members of the family.
Right.
But again, you know, I just decided that I had to try to find a positive way to get through it. So I ended up going to university, thankfully. 7 years of student loans, paid every one of them, and got my commerce degree, my marketing degree from MUN, which was a great experience. It was good because I was able to work through it. Physically work through the course and get a lot of good work experience. So I've done a lot of stuff business-wise as well.
Yeah.
I had been a sales manager for an oil company,
right.
The name, in Newfoundland and Labrador. And I'll go back quickly. While I was in university, I developed arthritis.
Yes, that's when your diagnosis came through, right?
Yeah, of all things.
For a musician to have that kind of diagnosis.
Well, I'm in my last year of MUN. Music was a bit of fun at the time.
Right.
I played drums in a band here in Mount Pearl, as a matter of fact.
Right.
Long hair and headbands and armbands, and I was, you know, it was us and Motley Crue and no one else.
You miss Neil Hammond, right?
Yeah. So, but, you know, I was about a year away from finishing university. And my right knee blew out, and I know it was from the stress that what I was going through at university. It was just the craziest courses, and you know, when you do the co-op program at MUN for business, I mean, it really puts you through your paces.
Yeah.
If you get through it, you're gonna do all right.
Right.
That's it. That's the first part of the challenge is getting there.
That's your test. That's what filters a lot
exactly.
of people out at that point.
It goes down from there.
Right.
So it was stressful. I saw doctors. I saw specialists. And I remember a doctor from Calgary who put her hand on my shoulder and said, Rod, you're going to be in a wheelchair by the time you're 35.
Wow.
We just want to let you know that.
What a thing to hear.
To
what
be prepared. And I'm 22.
That's got to be devastation at that point.
Again, okay, what do we do now?
Yeah.
What do we do now? So being a year away from finishing my degree, a starving student, I had every sample of drug that the doctor could give. And that's what I took that for a year or so. All to say, I went on, I became a sales manager, I did a lot of good things in business.
You had a very successful career at that stage.
Oh, I was, doing really, really well. Married, two kids, everything is great. The house, two cars, whatever. Living the dream. And so I always had something nagging inside of me that I wanted to do something for the Arthritis Society.
Right.
And I don't know why or... I don't know what made me feel that way. I mean, I suffered, and I said, bottom line is, we got to try to do something.
Right.
So I contacted, it was Christmas Eve, 1999, I contacted the executive director, and I said, and very she reminds me of it sometimes. I said, I got a dream to help the Arthritis Society. And I said I was either going to do a recording and give proceeds, or I was going to write a book, which I still haven't done yet, but I got notes like this that I am definitely going to write.
The memoirs are there, right?
I definitely am going to write a book about a whole lot of different things. Yeah. So she said, wow, great. So I met with the executives. I got involved with the Arthritis Society and helping them into marketing and stuff.
Right.
And it worked. We recorded an album. We had the whole thing recorded. Recorded with Von Rausel, Von Co Entertainment. Von was a producer at the time. And when we were all done, we had some great musicians, Corey Tetford, Dave Fitzpatrick.
Corey Tetford, yeah, another Grand Falls native.
Yeah, it all comes around.
Absolutely.
You know, Boomer Stamp, all of the guys who were very well known.
A lot of great names in the industry.
A lot of great names, yeah. We were finished the whole project, and Von and I went out for coffee. And we started talking about our lives. And of course, his dad is Bobby Evans.
Bobby Evans, right.
Who was probably toward the world.
Anybody in the music scene in Newfoundland knows who Bobby Evans is, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. So we talked about his past, my past, and he said, you know, boy, he said, there's a song in that. I'll never forget him saying that. There's a song in the story.
Right.
So he wrote the music, I wrote the words, and we created a song called She Still Guides Me.
She Still Guides
Me. Which is about my mother. And the impact, the long-lasting impact that she still has on my life today.
Right.
And it went through, you know, how it affected my dad. And it was amazing because I had been a sales manager who did this as a fundraiser. And as being as humble as I can be, all of a sudden, I got Factor funding to fly to Toronto to do video, toured right across to Edmonton. We had all kinds of attention from the East Coast Music Awards, Music NL Awards, you know, MIA NL back in the day. And so it was a whole lot of fun. So I shifted gears, I set up my own company, and got into the marketing advertising business myself at that time, while still, because I wanted to have more time. It was starting to become a lot of fun.
Yeah.
You know, we had done a couple of salmon festivals with the biggest names, and you know,
and Salmon Fest is when you've made it in Grand Falls, because Salmon Fest was the biggest thing that we had in Grand Falls.
And back in the day, I mean, you know, sitting back having a black horse with Tom Cochran talking about his life, and he's talking about the kids that he helps in Africa,
right.
And I'm talking about the people here with the arthritis thing, and it was
awesome. That's a story for the grandkids, right? Me and Tom Cochran go way back.
Well, you know, no, I would never say that, but certainly, I'm sorry if I threw a name there, but I just... You realize that these people are regular people who do the same things we do. And so that's why I say this, the band laughs at me. I couldn't care less who we play with or open for. I don't care if the biggest, we're just going to go out and do what we do.
Just do what you like.
And I have no, you know, people, oh my, you know, we open for Toby Keith.
Yeah.
And he was the most down-to-earth guy that I probably ever met.
And he seems that way when you see him on TV. He seems like a good old boy, right?
What you got is, you know, what you see there.
Right? So from that song, She Still Guides Me, you guys made a video from that.
Yes.
And this was all building up then to the recordings that you did, for, like you said, for the Arthritis Society.
Yeah, well, the recording happened first.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, country music radio wanted to play it.
Right.
Once that happened, I just applied for Factor funding, and they got the backstory of my life.
Yeah.
And they said, well, we're interested in doing something with this. And, you know, I had received funding in a couple of different places, thankfully. And all of a sudden it worked, and we were around the road doing things that I never thought I'd ever do, right? But I also, you know, took time to speak for the Arthritis Society at different events and perform. And I did two marathons. I'm suffering with arthritis. I did two marathons for the Arthritis Society, one at Disney and one in Toronto. But I raised money to do that, raised awareness, and that's always been a big part of it for me.
Right.
So all to say, in 2008, I said, it's time for a break. My daughter was growing up, and I realized that if I didn't kind of change my ways, I wasn't going to see much of her.
Because your star's on the rise at this point. Things are starting to take off for you, right?
Yeah, a lot of good things are
happening.
We're
going to talk about that in a second. Yeah. First, we're going to throw to a music video.
Okay.
We're going to go to Angry All the Time. So you guys recorded this music video with Roger Maunder.
Yes.
And this is off of the recording that you just did recently, in the last few months, right?
We're still recording it.
Right.
The upcoming CD, which will be released in May.
So we're going to check out the music video from Rod Jackson and the Perfect Strangers, Angry All the Time. And then we're going to come back and talk a little more to Rod. Check it out.
is left of a husband and a wife. With four good kids who have a way of getting on with their lives. I'm not old, but I'm getting a whole lot older every day. It's too late to keep from going crazy. I've got to get away. The reasons that I can't stay don't have a thing to do with being in love. And I understand that loving a man shouldn't have to be this rough. You ain't the only one who feels like this world's left you far behind. I don't know. Strong now, the spitting image of you when you were young. I hope someday they can see past what you have become. I remember every time I said I'd never leave, but what I can't live with is memories of the way you used to be. Stay, don't have a thing to do with being in love. And I understand that loving a man shouldn't have to be this rough. You ain't the only one who feels like this world's left you far behind. I don't know why you gotta be angry all the time. Came and went since I walked out of your door. I never quite made it back to the one I was before. God, it hurts me to think of you, for the light in your eyes was gone. Well, sometimes I don't know why this old world can't leave well enough alone. The reasons that I can't stay don't have a thing to do with being in love. And I understand that loving a man shouldn't have to be this rough. You ain't the only one who feels like this world's left you far behind. I don't know why you gotta be angry all the time. I don't know why.
So that was Angry All the Time by Rod Jackson and the Perfect Strangers. Great music video, beautiful visuals in there, great
Thank
song.
You. Yes.
And so when we, before we showed the video, we were talking about your star was on the rise at that point. You were doing a lot of things, lots of big names you were working with, lots of opportunities, and you decided to step away from it.
Yeah, I decided to take a break. Mm-hmm. I was seriously getting to a point where I was spending more time away than I was at home. And, you know, the home and the two cars and the two kids and the wife came first for me, and they always did. So I made a conscious decision that I need to just take a little break. I always knew I'd be back, though. Right. I didn't know when or how. And many, many people over the years have said, man, whatever happened? Where did all that go? And I said, it's just not the right time yet.
So, Rod, it's great to see you doing this incredible backstory. A man who kind of steps away from the thing that was rising you up to focus on your family. Can't think of a more admirable thing, you know, and a better reason to do that kind of thing.
For me, it was natural, and I don't regret it, not a bit, because I always had that fire down deep to say I'm coming back. But, you know, it's fun. If you can't have fun doing this stuff, it's just worth it to get out of it.
And that's why we all do it to begin with, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, Rod, truly inspiring story.
Thank you
so much for joining us here today. And, guys, check it out. Rod Jackson and the Perfect Strangers coming to a town near you, I guess.
Absolutely.
There you go. Thanks, Rod.
All right, girls.
Mom. You said it's played again.
Workplace injuries hurt the most at home.
I'm not stupid. I wouldn't drink and drive. She relies on me. They're counting on me. I never put them in danger. But I did. And it cost me everything.
Impaired boating is impaired driving.
Call the Rogers TV viewer response line, email us, or connect with us on social media.
And welcome back to Out of the Fog. I told you were gonna like it. Joe Strait killed it. Thank you very much, Director Joe. Thank you very much, Mr. Rod Jackson. We look forward to hearing more from you in the future, and actually like immediate future, right now. From his hometown at Salmon Fest, live performance, here's Mr. Rod Jackson one more time as we say goodnight, a guy like me. See you next week.
We are on Ruston Avenue in the former town of Windsor, Grand Falls, Windsor now. And this is the street I grew up on. It warms my heart to be here because it's been so long since I've been on this road. Happiness is where your heart is, and that's what this road is for me.
Hearts and flowers, forget love letters, pain and anger. Get forgiveness, love ain't waiting for a guy like me. Debbie Johnson champagne, caught up in old flames. I ain't the son of outrageous fortune. Cash ain't status for a guy like me. So put me on the cool river. Take my words from me. Just me. Long black limousine, pictures and magazines, all night parties, beautiful people, no supermodels for a guy like me. I'm just a good man, I work my hands. I get the picture, I heard the message. Hell ain't waiting for a guy like me. Put me on the cool river. Take my sins from me. Fly me high on the big blue sky where there's no one ahead of me. Put me on the cool river. Take my pain from me. Fly me high on the big blue sky.
pain and anger. Get forgiveness, love ain't waiting for a guy like me. Put me on the cool river. Take my words from me.
You gotta take the good with the good, and I take the good.
Call the Rogers TV Viewer Response Line, email us, or connect with us on social media.